We're here. Through all the fake GTA 6 news, and now we're finally getting to see GTA 6. Just a little taste before 2025. I'm sure that y'all have seen the trailer to death. I mean, good Lord, what is it like? 104 million views? I'm sure y'all saw this by now. So without further ado, let's just give my thoughts on the trailer. And this is just mainly for me, because I want to just see this later when the game releases and, you know, time goes on, how I felt at the beginning and what we got. So let's jump into it. First things first, man, it looks great. It's kind of scary how good it looks. Look at that, man. Doggone, the beach is hitting. Now, I know this is all cinematic stuff. This could just be straight up cutscene things. GTA is good for that. I think even last year on GTA 5 or last year. I think even in GTA 5, when that trailer dropped and everything, you know, we saw like, you know, just the scene, you know, the world itself that we're going to be in. So, you know, I'm not expecting this to be comparable to gameplay, but all in all, man, this stuff looks good. All in all, man, it looks great. It looks so weirdly realistic. And I guess I don't really care for that per se, but it does. It looks miles better than GTA 5. And that didn't, I didn't think at all that that was gonna be a thing that could happen. If GTA 5 doesn't look that great, this is a step. Like the fact that this clip here with the girl twerking on the car, I did not know that this was a clip from the daggone trailer at first. It looked like something that somebody captured. Now, the only time I kind of caught it was when they just kept repeating it, and then it kind of looked a little funky. But other than that, man, being in Florida, perfect place to go, because with all the Florida man stuff of recent memory, that's kind of the best place that GTA can go right now. Going back to Vice City, I didn't play Vice City all the way through. Very familiar with it. San Andreas was my game. And Vice City was like, I liked it. I just didn't care to finish it, I guess. Maybe one of these days I would. Going back to Vice City is great for GTA simply because it definitely could display the upgrade that this game could have gotten. It's got opportunities to do a very country, dusty looking area. Then it's got the opportunities to do the city life, the nightlife, like, you know, all these scenes right here just look great. And that's the best way to be able to display what's new to come. I feel like they couldn't have done this in New York or in California or any city. I mean, unless they did like Tokyo, it feels like that's the closest place that you could probably get all these neon lights and, you know, showing this depth or density to really display the upgrade. I was always wondering if GTA ever upgraded to a point where they look too realistic. Will it feel weird like shooting any of these NPCs? And I don't know. Once again, cinematics. So they definitely are at their best. So it shows the world, but you kind of have to take it with a grain of salt, I guess, you know? And you know what? We may get it and it'll actually look just like GTA 5 in a way, but I think that's just probably recency bias kind of thing. Well, once you get it, you get used to that look, and then you can go back to GTA 5 and compare and be like, oh, definitely seems more washed out. But other than that, man, I'm excited. Then another thing is, I'm very curious on what the story is. I didn't really think nothing of them like not showing anything story-wise. It's kind of early to show that. We kind of want to see the space that we're going to be in first. And I feel like that's enough hype to kind of keep that going for a while. But as far as the like social media stuff that they show in here, I feel like that's going to play a part in the story in a way that maybe helps our protagonists like get messages across or find people in a way. I feel like Grand Theft Auto has really acknowledged that, you know, this is recent. like, this is what's going on currently in the world. I mean, not like highlighting it, but there's a lot of themes to it. The thing that kind of solidified that whole thing of social media playing not a huge role, but a role, was her saying,
"The only way we're gonna get through this is by sticking together, being a team."
And right there is where I kind of went, you know what? That feels like a good message to kind of, I don't know what they're rallying for, but that's a good way to kind of send that message of like rallying people together to be like, the only way we can get through this is sticking it together. I don't know for what reason, obviously. It might not even be that big of a deal, but I think to achieve whatever they need to achieve, that is a way to think about it, I guess. Just theorizing here. But we see that one of our main characters is Lucia, which just a little bit that I got of her, I'm already sold. I was worried that like a new character in GTA would have been difficult simply because, you know, the expectations of a main character in GTA has risen over time. All in all, I'm sold on Lucia. Like, I'm rooting for her, whatever she got to do. I feel like her story is very situational. You know, she got caught up and stuff, and you know, maybe it's like not redemption, but you can sympathize for her. Curious on how Jason is, because Jason could be annoying. He could, or we're calling him Jason. We're just gonna call him Jason for now. He could be annoying, but we'll see. We'll see. One of the things that I am worried about, the cash grab of it all. I know Rockstar has spent a lot of time working on this, and if it's a good game, it's a good game. And just by the way that they operated GTA 5 with all the shark cards and online play and all this stuff, it just worries me to be like, it's kind of gonna be a huge, I ain't gonna say paywall, but just a huge emphasis on maybe money. And I guess if the game is good, it might be worth it, but I just don't see how good a game can be that good to justify like the amount of shark cards and in-game currency you need to play that game. And granted, I'm talking about GTA 5, which is had to kind of get to a point that was very like, I ain't gonna say playable, but had to get to a point where I guess it was playable. I'm just gonna say that. But that paywall makes me feel like, you know, the RP servers might be nerfed, or they might, you know, put a paywall to doing RP stuff. Trying to do their own thing, you have to go through them, and maybe it's limited. I just feel like it's not going to be as free, with all sense of that word, free to do what you want, to be able to add character to it. And this world has so much potential of being a good RP world. It just feels like it'll suck for that to be limited. Another thing I'm worried about is hopefully there's enough to do around town. I don't expect it to be very, I'm not asking for like crazy things to do around town, but I just want it to feel worth it. And it's kind of like why Red Dead always seemed a little hard for me to get into, because it's the time, it's hard to make that place feel quote unquote lived in. I love the fact that everybody kind of had a cycle that they kind of went through, like the characters were the best that you can do. When you're playing a GTA game, you kind of want to do not more things, but just feel like it's worth exploring, it's worth diving into. I hope that it is, but I wouldn't be surprised if it's not. I don't know exactly what activities it needs to be, but something. And the last thing I'm worried about is the game being so hyped that it can't live up to the expectations. So no matter how good the game is and how it plays, the changes that were made, the expectations and speculations outweigh the game in general. And that sucks. Sometimes stuff like that happens, especially since it's been so long, which is kind of crazy to say because GTA 5 came out when I graduated. And I feel like these 10 years has kind of gone by pretty fast, but it seems like it's been a long time since this game has gotten another installment. But let's end it on some positives. Things I have hope for or look forward to. I saw the Lowriders, and I'm like, first thing that came to my mind is when in San Andreas, you was able to customize your car, get the little hydraulics, have it sitting up. If that's in the game, I'm happy. That's all I want to see. Just go to whatever customs. I don't know what Vice City had, like a customs, but whatever it is, just give me that. I'm happy. I ain't gonna say it's the only thing I need, but you know what I'm saying. It's a stretch, but it would be so great. A co-op story mode. Just the fact that we have a Lucia and potential Jason here, that'd be great to be able to get to play this game. Co-op mode, we could do it online. I would love it to be local, but I know money is in online, so I get it. But it'd be cool to just be able to explore that world with someone in the story mode. You get the fluff out of everybody else kind of just being around. But I think it would be very cool if it's co-op. What's that game called? No Way Out? Like, that kind of vibe was pretty good. You know, it's fun to just be able to, you know, play a story mode with your friends. Just saying. It's good content, you know? Because even when you're trying to do some heist or you're trying to do a robbery or whatever, it's funny when you just, you know, you got a friend that just slips up while you're trying to finish a mission. I guess that's what's online for, but it'd be cool to see it in story mode. I'm just saying. I hope this game has some replayability. I think GTA 5 was fine. I didn't want to go through the story mode again. I didn't mind it. It was cool to like go through the story mode with mods and things, but as far as out of all the other story modes, I enjoyed the San Andreas, GTA 3, the Liberty City stories. So I enjoyed those story modes way more than GTA 5. Could be more for nostalgia reasons, but I hope it has some replayability, because you know this game is going to probably be out for another 20. If it comes out in 2025, it'll be out at least till 2035 if we're doing the 10-year gap thing again, or at least until we'll hear about a GTA 7, which GTA 7 feels like it should just be Lucky Las Vegas. Did I predict GTA 7? Wait, hold on. I'm trying to get my little shot face. Get all this out. Replayability will be great for this game, especially since the world just seems so grand. And last for me, I mentioned it a little bit, but I hope that this game can be modded. I'm not a modder, so I don't know how difficult it was for GTA 5, but I hope it's not difficult to mod this game. I know I have not seen any PC news of like when that's going to drop. I'm predicting that it's going to probably be a minute. I get it. Optimize the game for the consoles. That's probably your best bet. And we probably should get the best product out of that. But I just want to see this world modded. I'm sure I'm going to see some pretty interesting mods that comes out of this game and in this world. And I'm sure that since people have been talking about the density of the world, you can add that like a tourist mod where, you know, the density of the NPCs is more, but you got to have a, you know, higher NPC or whatever. That is my thoughts on the GTA 6 trailer. I'm excited. 2025 doesn't really seem that far away. The fact that we got the announcement at the end of 2023, I think if we saw this in January of 2023, it would have probably felt like it's a while from now. But years go by so fast. So I just hope that the game is polished. It's good. It just needs a little bit of tweaks here and there. That's all. I just want a good game. That's it. Just want a good game. I don't need it to come out immediately. I've been fine for the past 12 years. So, well, as of 2025, it'd be 12 years. So I can wait. But if you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like, comment, share, and subscribe. And if you're excited for GTA 6, let me know in the comments below. Let me know what you want and what you're expecting. And I will see y'all next time. Bye-bye.